In the body that you are in to function in this dimension.
All right. Yes.
Your functioning is not based on the identity you have been given by man, but it is based on the function you have been given by God before you got here. And as such, first part says introduction. As such, we have to come to the understanding that we are spirit beings in a physical body. Yes.
That's right.
Because law demands that a body has to be housed in order to function in this arena, this dimension. So because You need a body in this dimension. God sent you through your parents here. The reason why you have not fit, the reason why you have felt so misunderstood, the reason why you always felt a little awkward, the reason why even when you thought you were a shelled up, hell-bound sinner, but you didn't quite sin like everybody else, was because God had his hand on you. And what you went through prior to your conversion was designed to peel back the layers of what you learned in this spring to reveal who you are.
Come on.
According to his design. And so I'm going to tell you now, I'm assassinating that in your mind and in your psyche that you have used as an excuse to tell God you somebody else.
It's good.
What you went through was designed to shape you so that you would come to understand who God is in ways that were needed for you to understand so that you could function in the power he's designed for you to exercise.
My God.
You can't have dominion if you don't understand your power. Because you have to know how to rule well. And you don't rule well by never going through anything. Experience is the teacher. Just tell God, thank you for my past.
Thank you for my past.
It doesn't define my present.
It doesn't define my present.
And it does not delay my future.
It does not delay my future. Yes, Lord.
Prophets, I wish I had brought my message Bible. If you have a message Bible, just go to a store and get, just go to the store. I mean, it's free. Go to the store and look at a message Bible, right? And go to the section right before Isaiah, Song of Solomon, Isaiah. Get in there, right? Song of Solomon, Proverbs, Isaiah, get in there. Get in the poetry books. But when you get to Isaiah, flip back a page in the Message Bible. Eugene Peterson, bless his heart for being in Maryland for a while, pastoring, and being given the unction to write the Bible in a common, everyday language. He wrote a page on prophets, the life of prophets. What prophets were actually like, quite peculiar. Very different. A lot of times, ostracized. Never fit in. No one fooled with them. No one played games with them. No one wanted to hang around them. Because they were spooked. Lack of better term. They were bothered by the fact that somehow God would talk to them. And when they spoke, things happened. Introduction. I just want you to understand some things about the prophetic activity in your life. I don't care how nice you are, how loving and sweet and kind you can be, everybody's not going to want to hang around you. And truthfully, you're not going to want to be around everybody. You're just not. Because you're so keen on wanting to hear what he is saying and wanting to be sensitive to what he is doing, that you understand that you can't have anything and anybody in your atmosphere.
Amen. That's right. Amen.
prophecy. Sadly, today it's pimp.
Yes, it is.
$20 line here. Yeah.
Come on.
$50 line here. $100 line here. To the point where those who really don't understand the gift, but want to raise funds, will call for some gnome to come. And will consider it a fundraiser. Amen. According to Jeremiah 1, I believe verse 10, going to the book of Jeremiah, he...